Hello and welcome to this mindful movement practice. My name is Elena Richmond. I'm one of the counselors at North Island College. And we wanted to put together a movement for students to just get into your bodies, maybe get out some of the little bit of aches and pains, and even some tools to help you in these times. So I hope you enjoy this today. A quick note to say in the beginning that we're not there and we're not doing it in person. So I'm gonna suggest some positions, some postures, but it's really up for you to listen to your body and make sure that it feels okay in your body. It's normal to have stretches that might feel a little bit like, ooh, okay, that's stretching, right? But we don't want any pain. If it's getting to the point where it's feeling very painful, specifically any sort of sharp, more electric feelings, then that's your body telling you that what you're doing isn't feeling good and that you should adapt and back off a little bit. And I'll show you a posture that you can always go to kind of as your what we call a home posture if you need to rest and come out of something. But you are the master of your own body, so really listening to that. So what is mindful movement? You probably heard the term mindfulness, mindful. What does it really mean? John Kabat-Zinn is the person that coined the term, although mindfulness practices come from the East for centuries. But he coined this term mindfulness to mean paying attention in a specific moment without judgment. So you think, oh, okay, paying attention in a specific moment sounds easy. It's actually not, and it's actually very challenging. And a large cause of states of anxiety and also states of low mood or depression can often be where our mind is going. So anxiety tends to be very far in the future, ruminating what if, what's going to happen, uncertainty, kind of going down what we would call the what if highway of that. And then low mood can be a bit more, our mind tends to be a lot in the past. We kind of get stuck of ruminating, thinking about an event, how it unfolded, our role in it, and that kind of thing. So mindfulness to actually be and bring your awareness to the present moment is actually a challenge. And that's why it's called a practice, because it's something to practice. So I invite you today to not just think, I'm not good at this mindfulness. I hear this a lot from people. I was one of those people when it was first introduced to me. I'm not good at this mindfulness stuff. And I would ask you, the first time you picked up an instrument or played a sport, were you good at it? It's something that takes practice. And mindfulness can show benefits. Research shows for low mood, for anxiety, for overall general feelings of well-being. Mindfulness has research has shown that it can help, and it can take as much as 10 minutes a day. So today we're going to combine mindfulness, and I'm going to sort of walk you through and prompt with reminders of that with some really gentle movement. A few things that you'll need, it might be nice to have a yoga mat or some sort of mat as a cushion if you're doing it on carpet, even for the carpet burn or even hardwood floors. It's nice to have some sort of a cushion. A camping mat could work, a yoga mat, an exercise mat, those like foamy kind of puzzle piece things. If you have anything, great. An extra blanket. So I have a blanket here. It can be nice for the relaxation we're going to do at the end. It can also be nice sometimes when we come onto our hands and knees just to have some additional padding for the knees. Some water. Although it might seem like we're not doing huge strenuous movement, it's still really important to stay hydrated because we are moving energy through the body as we do some twists. We actually are compressing our internal organs, so we need to make sure we're staying hydrated. I really recommend putting on some nice, relaxing music. I would have some on here, but I don't think the sound quality would be quite as good. So if you can still hear my voice, but also somehow find a way to play some really nice relaxing music in the background, that might be something nice for this practice. comfortable or loose clothing. I really don't recommend doing it in jeans, even though we got stretchy jeans. I recommend some loose clothing or just some activewear stretchy pants. Also best not to do this right after a meal. So if you have just had a meal, maybe come back to it in half an hour, that kind of thing, because we are going to be moving and a few things in the stomach, and it's best not to do it on an empty stomach. Depending what time of day you're doing it, it might be really nice to just like set the environment to something that feels very relaxing. So maybe that's having a candle or an incense stick if you're allowed them where you are, or maybe an oil diffuser or something like that. Maybe opening a window so you can feel the breeze. But just set your scene up, you know, if there's a bit of clutter, maybe take a few minutes, make your space feel as comfortable as possible. So I'm going to suggest you hit pause, go get your water, get your blanket, get all the things that you may need, and we'll begin when you come back. Okay, welcome back. I just want to start by offering a quote and a bit of an intention as you move today. So this is by Tara Brock. She is a world-renowned psychologist and mindfulness teacher. And her quote is, "Whatever you practice, get stronger. If you practice judging yourself every day, that gets stronger. If you practice recognizing, allowing, investigating, and nurturing, that also gets stronger. And it also becomes quicker to do that." So it's very natural as we move that our mind's going to go to different places, sometimes even judging places of, oh, I'm not flexible, or my body hurts, or I should work out, or all these things. And I really invite you to remember this quote of what we practice gets stronger. So if that comes up, maybe you can meet it with something else, a different words of compassion for yourself. Well, I'm trying this, I'm trying something new. Stepping outside of my comfort zone, it's never too late to start it. I don't have to be good at this, I'm just trying it, right? So inviting that today. So I'm gonna just adjust the camera a little bit here. So I want you to come into a comfortable seat. For me, this is comfortable right now. Sitting cross-legged is not gonna be comfortable for everyone. So you can sit like with your legs out, you can sit with one leg in, you can sit like this, but basically come into what is a comfortable seat for you. I'm going to invite you to close your eyes if you feel comfortable. And if not, I'm going to invite you to soften your eyes. So just sort of looking down on the floor, maybe close to you. And we're going to begin to cultivate our breath, coming into our more internal world. Cultivating our breath looks like taking deep inhales in through the nose, and exhales through the nose or mouth. Sometimes people feel that it can be nice to count the breath, so inhale, 2, 3, 4, and then exhale, 2, 3, 4. Continuing to do this on your own with your own natural breath. I want you to bring your awareness into the space that you're in. Maybe notice any sounds that you hear in your space. Maybe some distant sounds outside of your space. sensing the temperature in the room. You bring your awareness to the tops of your hands or to the very tip of your nose, just noticing if it's slightly cooler than body temperature or slightly warmer. It might be helpful to, if you're kind of doing this in the middle of your day or whatever part of your day, some people like to imagine a backpack. And in that backpack, they're putting everything that they have to do or things that have happened. You can imagine yourself kind of loading it up with things you have yet to do, or maybe things that have happened in your day. And I want you to imagine just sort of leaving that outside of the space. It will be there for you at the end of this practice. Continue to take some deep breaths.
Find a comfortable seat. We're going to let our head come down towards the right. Inhale your shoulders up and back. You can take one or both hands out to the side. This may increase the stretch. See if your shoulders can be relaxed. Inhale, let your shoulder come back to neutral. Just do a little head bobble, like those little figurines in the dash of a car. And then let your head come down towards the other side. Shoulders are relaxed and down. Nice deep breath. Inhale, back to neutral, head bobble. And kind of move it gently from side to side. And we're going to inhale over to the right. Exhale, tuck the chin in towards the chest and look over to the left. And then inhale over towards the right. Linking breath, exhale to the other side. So we're linking our breath with movement. Remembering those nice deep breaths that we started with. And coming back to center. Inhale your shoulders up towards your ears, squeeze. Exhale, release. Inhale up. Exhale. It can be nice to exhale out the mouth here. Inhale up. Inhale up. This time, exhale. Roll the shoulders behind you, engaging the shoulder blades on the back. You can hear a few little crickety creaks here. That's usually pretty normal in this tension area. Now, inhale. Exhale. Roll forward. Rolling in now. Wonderful. Let the movement come into your waist, your center line. Exploring your space here from your center. Nice big circles, maybe as you link your breath. And the other direction. Coming back to neutral here. Nice deep breath. We're going to take our hands towards our shoulders, and as if we had lasers on our elbows, just do some shoulder circles, like we're shining the light from our elbows. And then the other direction, we're just waking up our body, our shoulders. Wonderful. We're going to take one hand out towards the side. Exhale over with the other side. We're finding a stretch in that side area there. Finding a nice spot for the neck. You might look down, maybe look up. Something that feels supported for the neck. And exhale down. Inhale the other side, up and over. You don't want to stretch too far and have a crunch. Just looking for that nice stretch. Along our side ribs. Inhale, come back to our center. We're going to take our hands in front of us and just do some circles at the wrist. So rolling them maybe in towards each other and then the other direction. Great. Shake it off. Yeah, shake it out. Good. Inhale, arms up. We're going to take the right arm underneath the eye of the elbow into the eye of the hand. You might find the backs of your hands together, maybe the palms of your hands together. What we're going to do is we're going to take our elbows and arms away from us as we take our back towards our back wall, finding a stretch in that upper spine. Breathe here. Exhale, release. Maybe look up. And then the other side. This time we're going to take our hands out and we're going to take the opposite arm underneath, eye of elbow together, and then back of the hands. One side might be different. We take our upper back and our arms forward. Nice deep breaths here. Release, maybe look up. I'm going to come into butterfly. So taking the soles of the feet together, you can have them further away from you or closer to your body. It's going to have a different effect. Whatever feels comfortable. Imagine a string from the top of your head slightly pulling your spine nice and straight, and with a flat back, come down towards your legs, down towards the floor. Your body will let you know the limit. And when you get to that place that feels good, then you can round your upper back, relax your head into the posture. We're going to stay here for a couple really nice deep breaths. Notice where your thoughts may travel and see if you can bring it back to the breath. Inhale, slowly, slowly come up. Look up. We're going to take our hands behind us. Feet come as wide or wider than the mat. We're going to drop the knees from one side to the other side. This is called windshield wipers. Helps move that last pose through the body. Wonderful. We're going to extend the left leg out, right leg comes in towards the body. We're going to inhale our arms up. And we're going to remember that string, nice tall spine. Exhale, reaching forward with our hands as far as we get to. We might come to our shin or ankle. Bottom of the foot, and we're going to do a sitting forward fold. See if you can relax your jaw, relax your forehead. Take a few more deep breaths here. Inhale, slowly come up. Legs come wide, windshield wiper. Other leg. So this time my left leg's coming in, right leg extending out. Inhale, arms up. Nice straight flat spine, forward fold. Wherever you get to is wonderful. And see if you can really relax into the pose from there. Imagine every exhale, you sort of sink deeper into the posture. Next, inhale, slowly come up. Arms come behind, legs come out, and windshield wiper. Knees from one side to the other. Great. Okay, you can grab your blanket. We're going to move into our tabletop, so it can be nice to have a pillow or a blanket underneath your knees. You can set that up. So coming into hands and knees, the fingers are engaged, like you're gripping a basketball, gripping into the mat. Toes are tucked. Inhale, head up. Sit bones out. Exhale, rolling the spine inwards, just like we see cats do. Inhaling, sit bones out, looking up, sternum forward. Exhale, rolling in. We're just waking up our spine here in this gentle movement. Maybe a little wiggle could feel nice. Great. We're going to try a little core. So inhale, it's called sunburn. We're going to reach out with our right hand and left leg at the same time. Be aware of your center body, that center. See if you can keep it engaged. Exhale, release. Other side. Inhale, reaching out with left hand, right foot. Think of a long line of energy between the heel and the fingers. Breathe. Exhale, release. Good job. From here, I'm going to show you child's pose. This pose is always available to you. Knees can be wide or together, arms stretched outwards, or they can come behind you. Whatever feels comfortable. It's a very nice resting pose. Few deep breaths here. Inhale, slowly come up. We're going to come into downward dog. We tuck the toes. Hands and fingers are engaged. Inhale, lifting the hips up and back. Sit bones to the sky. We can pedal the feet into the mat, pressing the heels one at a time. Reach your sit bones even higher to the sky and then see if you can straighten your legs slightly. You can feel them stretching the back from the quads all the way down. And then maybe try a hop to the front. Just play around. Or maybe just step one foot the other way till you come to a forward fold. Take a deep breath here. Inhale all the way up. Notice what it feels like to be standing. We're going to reach back with our right foot, 45 degree angle. Our hip bones are facing forward. Inhale, arms up towards the ceiling. Nice bend in the front leg. See if you can relax your jaw. Remember to breathe. Our next inhale, we're going to open our hip bones to the side wall, coming into our warrior two. So you have to might adjust your back stance, gazing over those front fingers. Inhale, reach up, look up, straighten front leg. Exhale, bend in. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, bend. Beautiful. We're going to turn that left foot in, so both our toes are pointing the same direction. Hands come down to our hips, and we're going to forward fold here. You can stretch your hands out in front of you. Let your head come down. Noticing that stretch in the back of the legs. Is your neck relaxed? Is your face relaxed? Deep breath. Hands come to hips. Inhale, come up. Beautiful. Now we're going to turn our right foot out, coming into a warrior on this side, 45 degree in the back leg. Inhale, arms come up, bend in, breathe. As the postures get harder, remember to stay connected with your breath. Inhale, adjust towards warrior two, sit bones turn the other direction. Gazing out towards the front fingers. Inhale, straighten the leg, arms up, look up. Exhale, bend down. Oops. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Beautiful. Breathe. Right foot's going to come in. This time we can interlock our hands, clasping behind our back if it feels okay. So we exhale, we bring our hands up and over. If this feels okay in the shoulders, if not, you can keep your hands on your hips. Relax your head, relax your jaw, relax your facial features. Inhale, slowly come up. And we're going to do a little hop, boop, back to our center. Wonderful. Tree pose. Hands come to hips. Left come onto the toes, bending right foot comes to maybe ankle, shin, and maybe even you can help it come to the thigh. It can help to look at a place to focus your gaze, your eyes to stay steady. Maybe your hands come up, maybe they come towards the center, or maybe they stay on your hips. Just play here, have some fun, and remember to stay connected with your breath. Slowly come out of that. Great job. Shake it out. Shake it out. And again, we're going to plant our right foot, all toe mounds into the mat. Come onto our left toes. Maybe our foot comes towards our shin. Maybe even our thigh. Just have a little play. You can also use a wall and help you support yourself in your balance. And find where you would like to place your hand. Or trees, it's normal to sway. Maybe you can even turn the side of your lips up. Remember to breathe. Exhale, release. Great job. Shake it out. Beautiful trees. We're going to come into our squat position. Inhale our hands up. Exhale, we're going to take, chair pose. Chair pose. Sinking down into a chair, bending the knees, reaching up. Exhale, hands come towards our chest. We're going to turn towards the right. Take left elbow towards the outside of right knee. And again, our neck could be looking down, it can be looking up, whatever feels suitable. Exhale, release, forward fold, shake out the head. Maybe clasp the arms with the elbows. Next inhale, come back to chair. So sinking down as if we're sitting on our chair, arms reaching up. We're going to exhale our hands towards our center and twist towards the left this time. Right elbow finds left outer knee. That right hip may want to come forward. See if you can keep your hip somewhat in alignment. Take some nice deep breaths here. Exhale, release. Shake it out. Maybe come onto the tippy toes, activating the back of the leg. Inhale, slowly come up. Now we squat. So inhale, taking our hand towards our heart center. You're taking your feet out and wide, and you come down to sit. It could be nice to have a pillow to help support this. You can take the elbows towards the inside of the knees and just gently help guide them outwards. And if you don't come anywhere close to this, that's okay too. Just play around, see where you get to. Exhale, release. You can move the pillow. And we're going to come onto our backs. Lying down, take a moment here. Arms out, palms up. Notice what it feels like to just be laying down for a moment. Take our feet in towards our body into what we call our bridge pose. Bending the knees. We're going to inhale. We're going to lift our sit bones, our bum off the ground. You can tuck one shoulder at a time underneath each other. And then lift your head slightly so you're pressing into the back of your head and finding space there. Breathe. Exhale, slowly release. Extending the legs. Take a moment, pause. And take the right knee, hug in towards the chest. The other leg is relaxed. Inhale the leg up, and then our hand will find our shin, our ankle, maybe the very top of the foot. This is our one-legged happy baby. It's a relationship where we're almost pulling down the leg as we also lift up, getting into our hips. Bend the left knee, right ankle finds left knee, and to thread the needle. So our hands can come underneath our thigh, our quad, or on top of our knee. You can take your right knee sort of away from the body, which will increase the stretch too. Stretching out the side glutes. Exhale, release. And then we're going to come into a twist. So twisting over towards the left. Our shoulders remain on the mat. Doesn't matter if our knees come down to the ground. You can put a pillow to support them. We're doing a gentle spinal twist here. Release. Come back to your neutral lying down position. Take a nice deep breath. Inhale, hug left knee in towards chest. Take the sole, the bottom of the foot up towards the sky. Again, our hand may find shin, ankle, bottom of the foot. If bottom of the foot, it's a gentle pressing down into the foot as you press your leg into your hand, getting into the hip socket. Breathe. Bend right knee, left ankle finds top of right knee, and again, either grasping behind the quad, behind or on top of the knee, thread the needle. Seeing if you can relax your jaw or notice if you're holding any unnecessary tension anywhere. And then bring it over into twist on the right side. So knees come down towards the right. Shoulders remain relaxed. And you can look towards the knee, or if you want a little more, you can look in the opposite direction of the knees. Nice deep breath. Inhale, untwist. We're moving towards our final relaxation. You can grab a pillow for under the knees. That can feel really nice. I'm going to get cozy with a little blanket on top of me. So make your space nice and cozy. Legs stretched out. Arms behind, by your sides, maybe palms up. Taking this moment in your day to just relax. The teacher says after we do movement like this, it's a moment for us to download what we've just done. And taking this moment to download. Feeling the weight of your legs, your center body, your arms, your shoulders, your head, all supported by the mat, sinking in deeper. Relaxing your jaw, tongue in your mouth, your eyes and the eye sockets, your forehead. Take this moment of relaxation until you hear my voice again. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale. Finding a little twinkle to the toes, to the feet. Maybe stretching your arms overhead, pointing your toes, stretch. This new moment. Feel free to stay exactly where you are. If you are ready to move and get on with your day, you can come onto one side slowly, slowly. And then when you're ready, coming back towards the seated position. Or legs straight out, whatever feels comfortable, keeping your gaze soft. One last deep breath here.
Thank you for joining me today. Hope that there was some benefit, or maybe you learned something new about mindfulness or yourself today. We'd love to hear from you as well. If you have any comments about this, please, you can let us know. Our manager of student life, Dean Martin, at dean.martin@nic.bc.ca. Counselors can also help students with developing more of a mindfulness practice in counseling appointments as well at North Island College. I'm going to leave you again with this quote because I think it's so important in these times by Tara Brock. Whatever you practice gets stronger. If you practice judging yourself every day, that gets stronger. If you practice recognizing, allowing, investigating, nurturing, that also gets stronger and also quicker to cultivate. So hopefully in these times you're also practicing being kind to yourself, watching the thoughts that you have in your day, and wishing you all to be well, and hope to